Metformin has been the first choice for diabetes treatment for a long time, and it's a consensus first choice. Everyone pretty much agrees that it should be the first choice. The reason for that choice is that it really fulfills all of the kind of check marks that you'd like for a drug for a very common disease.
In terms of how you guide the patient to titrate their metformin, you have to look at who your patient is. There's a combination of things that we would do to help somebody who has difficulty with taking metformin.
The mechanism for low B12 with metformin, I don't think has been completely sorted out, but it appears to be a problem with absorption. It's not related to intrinsic factors, so the sort of classic pernicious anemia that we all learned about in medical school, that's not really the mechanism, but there seems to be something about the effect of metformin in the gut that impairs absorption.
The long-term results of the DPP tell us that the effect of metformin to be beneficial in terms of preventing progression to diabetes or delaying progression to diabetes, that effect persists over the entire 15 years of follow-up, and it's looking to persist into the predictable future.